As you can hear, my solid-state Tesla coil can now play music with its aux. But the question is, how did I do that? Well, in the last episode of this project, I implemented an interrupter, which can turn on and off the Tesla coil with a variable duty cycle and frequency. So by using, for example, a frequency of 200 Hz, the aux turn on and off 200 times per second, and thus create a 200 Hz tone. But in order to play back proper music instead of random frequencies, we firstly need an SD card module. We need to connect it to an Arduino according to this schematic, before we can move on to the programming and the SD card setup. For first test, I utilized a simple example sketch from the TMRH20 library, which you obviously firstly have to download and include in your Arduino software. After uploading it, I used an online wave converter set to 8 bits, 16 kHz and mono to create a compatible audio file, renamed it to music.wave and copied it to the SD card. Once I plugged in the SD card, I connected a small speaker to pin 9 and ground of the Arduino and enjoyed the first playback of the music after powering the system, which actually didn't sound that terrible. And if we take a look at the audio waveform on the oscilloscope, we can see that it is a PWM signal with a frequency of 32 kHz and a modulated duty cycle, which should be suitable for the Tesla coil circuits. So I created a fitting female header, soldered it to the perf board and connected it to the Arduino. Afterwards, I changed the interrupt pin connection from pin 5 to pin 9, plugged in the SD card module and card, and verified that everything worked correctly by listening to an entire song played by my Tesla coil. But to improve the interrupter even more, I added a couple lines of codes which play back music if an SD card is inserted, or create the usual interrupter signal with variable duty cycle and frequency if no SD card is inserted. And with that being done, the interrupter section of the Tesla coil was completed. Another problem I noticed though while powering the Tesla coil was the rather high current consumption of the system, whose cause were the IGBT drivers themselves. The problem is that the IGBTs turn on faster than they turn off, which means that the drivers create a brief moment in which all IGBTs are partly turned on, and thus create a short circuit. What we need is a dead time, which delays the turn on of the next IGBT pair. A similar driver IC, which includes this feature, is the IR2184. For testing purposes, I soldered extension wires to two 8-pin IC sockets, placed the two new drivers inside them, and connected them to the corresponding pins of the old IGBT driver sockets. After powering the circuits, we can see that the current consumption decreased quite a bit, while we can still create the same aux as before, which basically means that the IR2184 are more appropriate drivers for this application. So I had to completely remove the 14-pin sockets of the old drivers to replace them with the 8-pin sockets, and establish the necessary connections to the complementary components. Afterwards, it was time to solve the last problem, creating a feedback system which keeps the primary coil's voltage at the resonance frequency of the secondary instead of having a fixed oscillation frequency. For that, I added a 555 timer circuit to the perf board, which creates a PWM signal that initially controls the IGBTs, but then will be replaced with the signal received by the 1.5 square millimeter wire antenna, which contains the resonance frequency of the secondary tank circuits. After connecting the feedback circuit to the Schmidt trigger IC according to my revised schematic and switching to the feedback system through the help of the jumpers, it was time to power up the circuit. At an input voltage of around 7 volts, the received signal of the antenna was strong enough to properly drive the IGBTs at the resonant frequency, which led to longer arcs and a nicer looking output voltage with only minor voltage spikes. Only problem was that even while using a voltage of 30 volts, the created arcs were certainly powerful and pretty awesome to look at, but not big enough for me. And powering the Tesla coil with mains voltage was not an option because of my limited workspace. So instead, we could unsolder the primary coil wires from the driver circuits and create a crude DR-SSTC, aka dual resonant solid state Tesla coil. That means, while up until now only the secondary side of the system consisted of a resonant circuit, this time we add a capacitor to the primary side so that we have a second resonant circuit. To find out the inductance of the primary coil though, I soldered it to the output of a Class D audio amp that I had lying around. And after removing the secondary coil, I connected the output of my function generator to the input of the audio amp, created a sine wave with the resonance frequency of the secondary, and measured the voltage and current through the primary. This gave me values of 7.6 volts and 523 milliamps RMS, which equals an inductive reactance of around 14.53 ohms. Since we know that the inductive reactance needs to be the same as the capacitive reactance, so that they can cancel each other out and only the very small resistance of the primary coil limits the current, we can adapt the formula and get a required capacitance of around 66 nanofarads. The closest capacitor I got was a 68 nanofarad one, which I soldered in series to the primary coil before I hooked it all back up to the driver. With this change, not only the current consumption increased by 1 amp, but also the overall length of the aux. Now at this point, I end my Tesla coil project, and while I know the results are not perfect, I hope it still motivates you to create something similar. Just be careful when dealing with high voltage. And of course, you can find more information about the project, like the schematic or code, in the video description. As always, if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Stay creative, and I will see you next time.